Welcome back to 8-Minute Automation. Today I'm going to show you another how-to video to how to create a function block in Omron PLC. Here you can see I just created a DOL starter with the function block. I just created a function block of DOL starter, and you can see the motor will be starting when I'm making it on and off. The output will be latched even if the start button or the start push button is off, and I'm making it off again. So this will be the DOL starter working, and that can be functioned through a function block. And you can see inside what's happening inside a function block. Here you can see what is happening inside the function block. This will be the base things or the back end of the function block. If you want to know more about this function block creation, you can continue watching. And make sure you just subscribe on my channel, and let's go. We can begin with the function blocks. So function block, right click on it and insert a new function block in ladder language. So we can close this function block property block, and we can double tap on the function block one that I just created now. And we just need a couple of inputs and outputs for my function block. I'm just creating a function block with a DOL starter, and go to the inputs. So I just need two inputs. That one will be start, another one will be stop. So I just right click here and insert a new variable. So these type of variables are working inside the function block, like start and stop. The data type will be boolean and usage will be input, and the initial state that can be false. And if you want to retain the values or make it retentive, you can check this and hit OK. And we can start with the next one. Insert variable again, that will be stop. So the normal input address cannot be given to the function blocks. That's why I'm creating my own local variables, and can go to the output next. And I'm just creating one output. Insert another variable, that will be motor. So this will be my output. And I'm just creating now overload protection again. Going back to the inputs, create a insert new variable, that will be OLR. OLR protection, or the overload protection. If the overload is affecting the motor, that will be stopping the working of the motor. So now I am going to create my own logic in here with this temporary variable start, stop, OLR, and the motor output. So with this, I'm just creating my own logic here. So I just place my first thing, start, that will be start. So just name it as start, and placing my motor output here. This will be motor. Okay, so start, and that will be motor. And if I just want to complete this run, click here and press the control and right arrow. So control and right arrow, so that will be completing the run. Next, I'm just making the latch for the motor, that will be here. Contact placed, that will be the motor itself. So now it's latched, and I just want to draw it up, control and up arrow. Then two NC contacts should be provided for the stop and the overload protection. Stop, and next will be overload protection, OLR. So I just completed my syntax, and then going back to my main program. Here you can see the section 1. So I just entered into this section, and I can create one contact. So this is my one contact that should be fed to the enable button for the function block. So I just want to make it always on. So you can see on the last, you can see P underscore on. That means it's an always on bit that can be provided for the working of the function block. And for placing the function block, I can see that here, you can see that after the instruction selection, you can see the new function block call is created. Take it and click here, and you can see the function block instance, and I can name it as DOL. DOL will be my name, and I'm hitting OK. We get the DOL starter function block, and we can see start, stop, and the overload. And here you can see the motor itself. So to give it name, we cannot place contacts like the ordinary function blocks. We just want to place the function block parameters right here. So I'm just making the function block parameters and placed one. First parameter will be 0. That will be actually it is 0.00. That will be the first input address, but I am using it as 0. And okay, and again click, that will be 1. Second input, and this will be 2. And the output will be starting with 100. So the first output will be 100. So 0 to 99 will be the input address for the Omron, and 100 to 199 will be the output for the Omron PLCs. So we just completed, and we can go compile the project. By compiling the project, you can see there will be no errors and zero warnings. So we can start our simulation right here. Work the online simulator. And we are came to the online mode. We just try the start and stop buttons by clicking here, press enter and hit 1, again enter. So I just started, pressed my push button, and again I'm releasing my push button by entering the 0 value. It is still providing the output. And if I press the stop button or the overload protection or the overload button, that will be stopping the motor. So that has been stopped the motor working, and that will be the DUL function block in the Omron PLC. So thanks for watching.